you are. Usually I find that in every piece of music there's a phrase that really sticks out to me, or a line that really convicts me, or something that makes me look at a truth in a new angle. And so my favorite phrase in this piece is, "A lifetime of worship would not be enough to thank you for all that you are." And I like how it doesn't say, "to thank you for all that you have done." Even though that definitely would be a legitimate prayer, I just know that for myself, sometimes I find that I only remember to thank God when I feel like he's doing something for me. And that was a little bit of a convicting thought. And so this is just a great reminder that we can thank God and we can worship God for who he is, not just for what he does for us. He's compassionate, he's forgiving, and he is fair. Don't let the syncopation slow you down in this piece. In a room this deep, in 6/8 meter, after about the first page, it's gonna be a little bit like wading through taffy. And so stay right on the top side of the beat. Keep those syncopations right in beat. And if you will give a little bit of a lilt to your voice, that will help keep you right with the tempo there. You will notice that, I just read my notes wrong there. We do have a part for the violin, which is awesome. And there are also instrumental or rhythm parts. If you would like to use a little bit of percussion, of course we don't have that here, and it works just beautifully with Karen and Chris. So let's go ahead and get started on this one, "For All That You Are."